So for our fifth day this morning, we have contemplated extending the trip so we can have an extra week in this beautiful part of the island, the northern part. And that's because we found a beautiful Airbnb for £80 a night, and it's got this lovely veranda outdoor section with an unbelievable view. But first, we need to have breakfast, so let's go. So before breakfast slash lunch, it's 11:30, we found a supermarket where we're gonna get some snorkeling stuff, because today we are going snorkeling in Palio Castrezza. Two omelets and a ham cheese toasty. Not bad. Coffee's great.
What did you think about the restaurant? Spiros, yes or no?
Yes, definitely.
Definitely.
It's the only restaurant that's open.
For me, the food was... the food was a 5 out of 10. So here we are in Afionos, which is the northwest part of the island, and we're going to hike down to Afionos Beach.
Well, it's Porto Timoni.
Porto Timoni Beach. I have no idea how you could manage this without a car, so you absolutely need a car. Got a swim shorts, got some snorkeling equipment, got my GoPro as well. I'm all prepared. I'm really annoyed because the one day that I really needed to bring walking boots, I forgot to bring them. I just put my trainers on. And for this hike down to Porto Timoni Beach, you absolutely do need a pair of walking boots, because this ground, it's so bad for your feet if you're just wearing a pair of trainers. But wow. After the most treacherous, longest hike I think I've ever done to a beach, we'll get to Pirate Beach at Porto Timoni, and it is honestly amazing here. The water is so, so blue, it's crystal clear. I'm gonna go for a swim in a second. It's not too busy, but that's probably because nobody's really traveling at the minute. But also there's no shops or no restaurants down at the bottom on the beach, so make sure you bring water, you bring snacks, because you're not gonna be able to buy anything down here.
These would fit.
These would fit.
Yeah,
ah, they would actually. Size 38. So I'm a size 10 and a half, 10. What size are these?
5.
Size 5. So we're gonna get a size 5 on my foot. Here we go, let's see if this works. Oh, it actually does work. I just put a little sand in there. No, it doesn't work, never mind. So the water's a little bit colder than it was at the other beach, and there's a lot more pebbles, but it is a lot more clear on this beach as well. I really should have brought my snorkeling shoes because, yeah, there's pebbles everywhere. Oh, it's freezing. But as they say, it's fine once you're in. Whenever I'm in water like this, I always get really concerned about sea urchins, the little spiky things on the floor of the water, because I have heard horror stories where someone gets their foot stung by one, and then, like, mad infection. I think one person told me that you can die from a sting from a sea urchin as well. And can you believe it? People eat them. Let me know if you've eaten a sea urchin in the comments. Let's go under. These goggles are absolutely ridiculously bad. I don't know who designed them, but they're just crap. I would just advise getting a pair of goggles rather than getting some of these diving snorkeling goggles, because, well, you all probably know, you've all probably used them before. But don't nip into a supermarket and pay €10 for a pair of
bit of tat like this. It just keeps letting water in, it's dreadful. I can only go under for like 5-10 seconds.
Wow.
Yeah, so it's the walk back that you absolutely need.
The snorkeling shoes.
Because the pebbles. Oh, I'll cut your feet.
No.
Why?
I'll stand here and you can go.
I'm trying to convince her to take some videos of me in the water, but it's quite cold. It is. I do agree. I'm actually hesitating myself as well. But I really want to get some shots of me swimming.
So we can come back tomorrow.
We can't come back tomorrow, can we? Because the hike's too much for his legs. Yeah, but that's not this beach. Do you want to come and have a look at this other beach?
No?
No, the other side?
I'm alright. No? I'll have a look on the way back.
All right. This is one side, and I'm going to go and have a look at the other side of the beach, which is over here. So once you've finished your hike down to Porto Timoni, there are two beach options that you can choose from. There's this side and there's also the other side, which we've spent more time at. Snorkel at both of them. The water's crystal clear. It's beautiful. This is possibly the better of all the beaches that I've been to so far in Corfu.
This is a very lovely beach. It doesn't have the same amenities, obviously.
Yeah, no amenities.
But if you came in summer, it might be very crowded.
Yeah, it wouldn't be the same. It's what? It's the end of summer, October. It's a little bit chilly as well. What temperature is it? 20, it's probably about 21 degrees, 20 degrees. 20, yeah, it's about 22 degrees. All right, 23, not 22, 23. And as you can see, there are still people on this beach. So summertime, it's probably not gonna be possible to even find yourself a place to lay. So I think it's about time we ask, how are we feeling about potentially extending?
No, I'm happy to go back, thank you.
You're happy to go back, are you?
Yes, I'm ready.
He's not.
£97 jet 2 on Saturday. To me it shows that at some stage, as it gets to nearer the time, they do reduce the prices.
They do start reducing the prices. Why are you so content with leaving tomorrow?
Because it's the end of my holiday.
But why would you want the holiday to end if you've got nothing to get back to? We're just going back to cloudy England, rain, lockdowns, we're just going to stay in the house.
Well, we've got planning.
Why are you okay with that? You haven't got plans. What plans? What plans have you got? You don't have any plans. Porto Timoni and Pirate Beach, you've been amazing. I will absolutely be returning. Now for the 40 minute hike to the top. I have heard you can hire a boat for a day, which will cost between 400 to 800 euros, I believe. Don't quote me on that. But that way you can just boat over to this area instead, privately.
I feel like I'm going rock climbing.
Now I realize what they mean when they say Corfu's full of hiking. This is what they mean. It's
what
exhausting.
He really means is he now found out just how unfit he is.
Yeah, exactly that. Exactly that. Always make sure you have a t-shirt if you come to a restaurant. Beach bars are the ones that you're allowed to wear nothing at. Restaurants, you have to wear a t-shirt. So, I'm borrowing my mum's t-shirt. What do we reckon? Thumbs up or thumbs down? Lovely. So we got some olives, two beers on the draft, and then of course the white wine with an amazing view of and of course more beaches and beautiful islands. How's the olive? Good?
They're pretty good.
Pretty good. So not excellent. I'll be the judge of how good the olives are. Here you go. Yeah, wow. So good. A lot less salty. I think these are a lot less salty. Clever tricks. Make the olives salty so they make you drink more. So we found Animos restaurant and we ordered the stuffed peppers for starters. Fresh, beautiful, and we've got a great view to watch the sunset, which is lovely.
It's the pasta studo.
Pasta studo?
Famous coffee dish, just to taste this map.
Is that big enough? How's yours? I ordered what he had.
Yeah.
It's all over your face.
Can't help it, it's so good.
Is it that good?
It's good.
Oh, lovely, thank you.
We both had the beef stufado and you had the pasta sado, two super Greek dishes, and probably one of the better meals of this entire trip, and we had an amazing sunset to watch. For our penultimate evening, it's still setting now, the view is spectacular over Alias, Arilas even. Can highly recommend this after being at Porto Timoni for your dinner.